Hello friends, in this video let's quickly talk about how to create a basic project in the Jupyter notebook for the first time. How to enter into a Jupyter notebook, how to start. There are like a couple of questions I got it, like a basic, how to create a basic projects or how to enter Jupyter notebook. And later we can explore like what exactly we can do with Jupyter notebook and all. So what are all the prerequisite we need to check before we create a first project in Jupyter? First of all, either Jupyter is installed or not we need to check. And before that we need to check either Python is installed or not. So how to check it? See, I have a plain Python IDE in my machine. After that I have installed a Jupyter. How to do the Python installation and how to do the Jupyter notebook installation, we already talked about in the previous videos. I'll keep you those links in the description section. You can watch that. So let me check what version of Python is running in my machine and what version of Jupyter network is notebook is running in my machine. So it's very straightforward and easy. So let's quickly go to the command prompt and check that. So what version of Python is running first? How to check the Python version is? It's very simple. Type Python space hyphen hyphen version. So once you click on it, immediately you see a answer. You see an answer, Python 3.7.4. That is a recent version which is running in the market as of now. Maybe if you see the video after like a couple of months, the version may vary, 3.7.5 or some different version. Now what is the Jupyter version which is running in my machine as of now? In a similar way, let's type that Jupyter space hyphen hyphen version. Once you enter it, you will see that. So Jupyter core 4.5.0, Jupyter notebook 6.0.1, Qt console and all. I don't have Qt console and IPY widget I do not have. Remaining all are I have. So why do we need this? We will talk about one by one. So now as of now I can say that I have Python is installed on my machine and Jupyter notebook also installed on my machine. Then how to start it first? So it's as simple as it is. Simply in the command prompt type Jupyter notebook. See, you can start the Jupyter notebook even from Anaconda Navigator as well. We will talk about that, how to start it, because I have installed Jupyter through pip installer. That is the reason why I am using command prompt to start the Jupyter notebook. If you have Anaconda on your machine, then you can start directly from Anaconda. So Anaconda contains other IDEs as well, Spider and all. So let's not talk about that. Let's not spend any time on that. Now let's Jupyter space notebook, enter it. So once you click on enter, it starts a console here. If you really see this, it immediately opens a browser. See, Jupyter notebook works on the browser. Parallelly, the one console is running. If you really see this, this is the console which is running. You can see this. If the browser doesn't open, you can directly copy these URLs and you can paste it in any browser. You will get this window like this. You can see it, some 3D objects, contacts, desktop and all you can see here. Then how to start here, how to write a program or how to write a hello world example here. So if you really see this, at the extreme right bit top you have a new, under that new, let's click on the new drop down, you have a Python 3 text file folder. Let's click on folder. I'm creating a folder for us. So there will be a folder here. I'm creating a folder, somewhere new folder might have come. Let me refresh this, where it is the folder, yeah. Let me click again once, new, okay, so that's fine, I think the folder should come here, yeah, here, I can see it, there are two folders, here you can see it seconds ago, okay, so I can delete if I want, let's click on one, and you have a delete button, let's delete that untitled folder, we don't need, now let's come to here. So let's select this. Once you click on it, you will get like this. You can rename this. You can rename this. Let's click on go back. Select this and you can rename it. So I'm simply renaming as examples. Examples. So I can keep the examples name. So that now let's go to the examples folder where it is. It is simply just created. Yes, this is a minute ago. It has been created if you see this. Okay, let's click on examples. So this is a place where I am saving all my Jupyter examples, Python related Jupyter. Now let's how to add a files to the folder. Let's in the similar way, in the extreme right top side, you have a new option. Let's click on that new option. Click on Python 3. It opens a window like this. And name of the file is untitled. So you just click on it to rename it. Once you click on it, it opens a window like this. And you give a meaningful name. So I'm just keeping as first project, first example, whatever the name I want. First example, rename that. Now you can see it rename. Okay, or there's a one way. And you want to say for every time you have a save and checkpoint. For every statement you write it, it saves it. Then where I need to write a statements here? So it looks like a browser window. So how to write a multiple statements, or how to write a multiple lines of code in the browser. Yes, this is a box. This box is the one which helps you to write a programming, Python programs. Here you need to write. So what I can write? So can I write something, whatever I want? Yes, whatever I want, just type it and enter it. Nothing will happen. So I want to calculate a sum of two numbers. So like a 90 plus 10. So how to get the output? I press it. I have okay. I'm okay. Like a 90 plus 10 is 100. I know, but I want to see through a Jupyter compiler or Jupyter runtime. How to see that? See, to see the execution of this particular statement, you need to use shift plus. I'm just writing. I'll wipe it off. Shift plus enter. Then you will see the output of the statement. If you simply enter it, you don't see that. If you simply, I'm doing simple enter. If I do the simple enter, it gives a separate line for us. It gives a new line for us. If you do a shift enter, now I'm pressing shift and enter. Now I can, once I press shift and enter, I can see the output of the 90 plus 10. See that 100, I can see it. So now 90 minus 10. You want to see the output of this? Yes, in the same way, press shift and enter. You have 90 minus 10, 80. Now I want to print some message. Hello world message. How to do that? So for printing, you can use a direct print word. Print. Print off. You can put whatever you want. Hello world. Hello world. So once you are done with your statements, so you want to see the output, let's do a shift and enter, hello world. Then you're okay, like, because till now I have only one line of statement. Then how to run multiple lines? Yes, let me do that. A equal to 10, so B equal to 90, then A plus B. Now I am done with my program, three lines of program. I initiated A, B, and I am planning to identify A plus B. So then let's press shift and enter. I can see the 100 now. So now A minus B, let's type A minus B. See, here I am not defining A minus B. In this block, I am not defining, but I defined somewhere at the top. Can I do A minus B? Can you guess it? Let's shift and enter here. Put a mouse, enter here. Yes, you can do that, because A and B has defined in the previous lines, because we are in the same file. You are in the same file, first example. You are in the same file, first example. That is the reason why you can use the variables which are declared earlier. So now you are in the example folder. You are in the examples. After that, you are in the first file. Okay. So can I write a factorial of a number? Can I write a prime number check? Or can I write a XML operations? Can I write a CSV operations? Yes, you can do whatever you want here. Can I connect to the SQL server from here? Yes, you can connect. You can connect to any RDBMS from here. But you need to import some namespaces. So this is how we do check and write a Python programs in a Jupyter window. If you really see, it is auto saved one. So whatever, when you, once you press enter, the code will be saved, because that's how the Python project in Jupyter notebook. Or you can say that like a save and checkpoint. For every second, for every minute, it saves. Whenever you press enter, it automatically saves. See, like a, see, earlier people used to have a different IDEs to write a like a normal projects, like a .NET having separate IDE, like a Java having separate IDE, but they don't develop the projects on the browser. But here, by using Jupyter, you simply develop and deploy everything from a browser itself. That's all about it, how to start a new projects in Jupyter, and how to initiate and how to check the version availability in a particular machine. So let's meet in the next video with a bit complex examples with a block of statements. So that's all about it. So please like and subscribe for more technical videos, and provide your valuable feedback on this. That's it. Thank you for watching. Thank you.